Well, good morning. John Summers here at one of my favorite places in Western New York, Barbara Oliver and Company on Main Street in Williamsville. I'm with the lady Barbara herself. And today we are going to talk to you about the care of your jewelry and how to clean it and do it the right way and the safe way. You look marvelous today.
Thank you, John.
So once they have made their purchase from Barbara Oliver and Company, we want the jewelry to be taken care of in the right way. And I think that's what you're all about this morning. So tell us what we're looking at here.
We're looking at homemade jewelry cleaner. In between visits to your jeweler, hopefully me, you can make your own simple solution at home. I recommend you not spend a lot of money buying the fancy schmancy little bottles of jewelry cleaner. It's very, very simple to make. If you're lucky like I am, you have the jars from your mother-in-law who does a lot of pickling and jams. This, you just take a plain glass jar. The amount of ingredients isn't important. It's just the ingredients themselves. Just put some water in, a little bit of just plain ammonia. Make sure it's not sudsing ammonia, just plain.
Now, see, I'm learning something already. I didn't know there were two different kinds of ammonia.
So. Of course. This is the kind that's not going to leave any residue on your jewelry. And then the best dishwashing solution is Dawn for the application. Joy would be okay, too. A couple of drops. What that's going to do is take all the cookie dough and soap and all the hand lotion that we've gotten on our jewelry just from normal wear. Just give it a little mix. And then the rule of thumb is any stone that is clear goes into the pool. Diamonds, sapphires, rubies, any of the amethyst, blue topaz, opals, turquoise. I said emeralds.
Did you say emerald?
I think so.
I like emeralds, so I wanted to say it twice.
Especially emeralds. Anything clear goes into the mix. Things like pearls, opals, turquoise, and any kind of stone that is like a jasper or a cameo doesn't need to go in there. Just lightly brush it, and then you can rinse it off in plain water, and then what you have is a sparkling, clean specimen that you're ready to wear all over again. When it comes to pearls, when you're going to put your pearls on. Hairspray, perfume, spray it on, but not on your pearls. You put your pearls on afterward. And after you're done wearing them, because pearls are organic and they really don't want the chemical attack, you just take a soft cloth, a little bit damp, and just wipe them gently. Just make nice on them. You don't want to put them in any water, especially if they're fully strung. And the reason for that is, after the string gets wet and the knots are wet, you're gonna loosen up the integrity of the strand itself. So just a gentle wiping to get the chemicals off. The same thing with opals and the turquoise that we mentioned before. The way to clean those properly would be anything that you would feel comfortable using to clean your skin is okay to use on those stones. But again, no harsh chemicals on the porous materials that they're made of.
Barbara, you're a graduate of the GIA, Gemological Institute of America. Tell me a little bit about that. What does that mean you're able to do now, being a graduate of that?
I'm basically a doctor of diamonds. It's a very intense course that we take. Grading of stones, both diamonds and color, being able to identify them scientifically, being able to judge stones on their color, their cut, their clarity, their value, their beauty, what makes one stone worth this and what makes one stone worth that, even though the paperwork says they are the same. There's a lot of different things because there's so many different types of stones to know.
That, and she told me something that's just amazing. You don't want to confuse hardness with toughness. A diamond is very hard and will cut other glass, and you can't scratch it, but a hammer would smash it to nothing. Whereas, what was it?
A jade.
You can scratch and deface easily, but it doesn't want to break under a hammer. That's amazing, the difference in stones.
Right. People think when they hear that a diamond is the hardest material on the face of the earth. It is. But it is not the toughest. There is a difference.
Barbara, thank you for your instruction in showing us how to keep our jewelry clean. Take a look at the screen on how to get in touch with Barbara and keep your jewelry in the best shape thanks to her. Stay there. Our program will be right back.